spending your evening with us tonight. Thank you for coming. I'm Nathan Hess. I am Associate Professor of Music and Coordinator of the Keyboard Area here at Mercyhurst. And I'm excited to be on stage tonight with my colleagues Sarah Kale, Linda Peters, and Micheline Guillo. So we're starting tonight's concert with Bizet's masterful overture from his opera Carmen. It is one of the most performed operas of all time, written in 1875 in Paris for the opera comique. The first section covers the main exuberant theme of the overture, and then that goes to the middle section that has the famous Toreador theme. Linda, could you play that for me? Recognize that? Yes. We thought this would be an exciting piece to get the program started tonight. Again, thank you for coming. And we hope you enjoy tonight's performance.
Thank you.
1864, while Mozart was still a teenager, the Sonata in B flat was written for Mozart and his sister Anna, and they were touring throughout Europe at the time, overseen by the very domineering father, Leopold. Natalie was considered as great a virtuoso as Mozart was, and the writing reflects that. Both parts are equal treatment, and both parts have equally virtuosic parts, with lots of running notes, leaps, and other pianistic technical demands. The first movement, the Allegro, is in sonata form, so we hear all the expected themes in all the right places, exposition, development, and recapitulation. The second movement is a lyrical adagio in ABA form, very operatic in style. It sounds like a soprano aria from one of Mozart's operas. And the last movement, a presto, it's also in sonata form, has short motives, very light, sprightly in character, bringing the piece to a cheery close. As is typical with most forehand works, there are several spots in the music where Christian and I have to fight each other to get our notes in. So you will see us with some choreographic moves. One hand will come out, an arm will come in, over top, and that's all carefully worked out. We had to work that out in rehearsal so we could get exactly everything in the score that Mozart has written. So we hope you enjoy Mozart's Sonata in B flat.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Our next set of two pieces are Latin American dances. The composer of the first one, Arthur Benjamin, was an Australian composer, pianist, and adjudicator who traveled widely. When he was in the West Indies, he came across a tune called the Mango Walk and based his best-known piece, the Jamaican Rumba, on that tune. As a thank you from the Jamaican government, he was given a free barrel of rum every year for the rest of his life. Benjamin also wrote scores for many films. The rumba originated in Cuba. The next piece, composed by Harold Triggs, was a native of Denver, Colorado, and had a long career as a concert pianist, and he was a teacher at Juilliard and Columbia. He wrote mostly piano music. So hope you enjoy these.
Thank you. 25th wedding anniversary. Originally, it was entitled, "The Well Wishes Are Coming." This element is still reflected in the opening section, which is very March-like. The place named Trollhagen is where Grieg built his house in 1885, and he lived there until his death. We hope you enjoy this arrangement for piano duet.
Thank you.
first movement showcases Poulenc's flair for rhythm and sudden dynamic shifts. You will hear dialogue between the two piano parts, as well as some interesting physical challenges when the primo part crosses over the secondo part. The second movement is a very simple folk-like melody with an ending that doesn't quite sound complete. And the third movement is very spirited and fast with rhythmic passage work. And you'll hear the thematic material from the first and second movements kind of come back in and woven throughout the movement. So we hope you enjoy this Poulenc sonata.
Thank you.
Dances, Opus 46, brought Czech composer Dvorak to unexpected fame in 1878. A musical publisher of Brahms by the name of Fritz Simrock asked Dvorak to write something for piano duet which incorporated musical themes from where he grew up. Dvorak was inspired by Brahms' Hungarian dances. Rather than composing a literal portrayal of the actual folk melodies themselves, Dvorak used the style, the spirit, and the rhythms of traditional Bohemian dance patterns. These dances were later then set for orchestra. As you can see, we have changed into our dancing shoes for this last set of dances. We hope you enjoy.